started.
Yes. So last class, children, last class, we have learnt exercise 4.1, question number
2, till question number 2, isn't it? So, yes. Let's revise once again. Let's revise the concepts once again.
So you all know how to multiply the 3-digit number, right? 3-digit and 4-digit number. 3-digit and 4-digit number. Yes. And children, take your classwork, keep it ready. Take your classwork, keep it ready. Children, simultaneously you can start writing your classwork. Okay, simultaneously you can start writing your classworks. So question number 2, let's revise the question number 2 again. So the last class we have learned till question number 2. So here Mumbai received an average rainfall of 2334 millimeter every year in the last 7 years. Okay, how much rainfall did Mumbai receive during the period? So 1 year, how much rainfall? 2334 millimeter. Okay, mm means what? Millimeter. So if it 1 year, if the rainfall is 2334 means, what about 7 years? Yes, we are going to do multiplication to find the answers. Okay, so 2334 into 7, if you multiply it, you will get the product. You will get the answer. Okay. So children, take your classwork. Simultaneously, you can start writing your classwork. Okay. So anyway, to complete your classwork, you need to spend separate time, right? So after finishing one problem, you can start writing in your classwork. But write neatly. Okay, children? Yes. So an average rainfall in a year is 2334. An average rainfall in a 7 year. So we have to multiply 2334 into 7. Okay. If you multiply it, you will get the answer as 16,338. So till here we have learnt it in last class. Okay. Till here we have learnt in last class. So next, let's move on to the next question. Question number 3. So children, come along with me. Take your classwork, sharpen your pencil, start writing. Okay. So anyway, in each and every class, I am solving 2 problems only. So you have enough time to write your classwork. Got it? So question number 3, children, no need to write. Tarun, what is this? Stop chatting. So children, listen, put date. Okay. Put mention the date. And no need to write, if the children, those who have textbook, you no need to write the questions fully. Okay, so question number 3. Put question number 3. That's it. That's enough. So question number 3. Kriti deposits 375 rupees in her bank account every day. Every day she is deposits 375 rupees. Okay. How much money does she deposit in a non-leap year? How much money does she deposit in a non-leap year? What do you mean by, what is the meaning of non-leap year? What is the meaning of non-leap year? What is the difference between leap and non-leap? Leap year means how many days? Leap year means how many days, Ekansh? Leap year means how many days? Yes, 366. Leap year means 366. Because in that leap year, the February month, will have 29 days. Okay. It occurs only after 4 years. Okay. It occurs after 4 years. Every 4 years, that leap year will occur. Okay. So the Feb month will have 29 days. So now here, listen, children. Non-leap year means it is normal. Normal year. 365 days. Leap year means it is 366 days. Okay. Now we are going to multiply 375 into 365. Okay, 365. Are you ready? Are you ready to do? So start writing the solution. Start writing the solution. So amount deposits per day. So how much amount she is deposit? 375 rupees. 375 rupees. Okay. So amount deposit in a leap year, in a non-leap year. Amount deposit in a non-leap year. So you have to multiply 375 into 365. Children, do the multiplications and tell me the answer. So we have to multiply these two. Amount deposits per day is equal to 375. Amount deposit in a non-leap year is equal to 375 into 365. Children, if you are very slow in writing, no issues. Anyway, I will be sharing this PPT through Google Classroom. Okay, so you can write your classwork slowly afterwards also, no issues. Those children can able to write fast, those children can able to come along with me, you can start writing it. Others don't worry at all. Okay, ma'am is going too fast. No. Okay, I'm going very, very slow. If you can come along with me, you can start writing classwork. Or else you can write after finishing the class. Anyway, I'll be sharing the PPT. Okay. So now we are going to multiply 375 into 365. Shall we start multiply it? Yes. Okay. 25. 5 here. 2 will be the carryover. Next. Children, listen. Here we have 3 digits. So you will get 3 steps answers. Then the 4th line only you will get the product. Got it? Here we have 3 numbers, no? So you will get 3 steps. You have to multiply 3 times for each and every number. Then the 4th step only you will get the product. So now 5 sevens are 35. 35 plus 2, 37. Children, and one more thing. After writing the carryover, after adding the carryover, please strike out the carryover. Okay? Previous carryover. Got it? Next, 5 threes are 15. 15, already we have 3 here. 15 plus 3, 18. Strike out. I have added 3, no? Strike out. So, 18. Next. So, next I am going to take 6. Take 6 and multiply by 6 5s are 30. So, this is second digit. So, we should start writing the answer under the second digit. 6 5s are 30. 3 here, 0 here, 3 will be the carryover. 6 7s are 42. 42 plus 3. 45. 5 here and 4 will be the carryover. Next, 6 3s are 18. 18 plus 4, 22. That's it. Next, take 3. Next, take 3 and multiply all the 3 digits. 3 is third digit, no? So, you must start writing the answer under 3 digit, third digit, okay? Remaining places, you must fill it by 0 or star. So, 3 5s are 15. 5 here. 1 will be the carryover. 3 7s are 21. 22. 2 will be the carryover. 3 3s are 9. 9 plus 2, 11. Okay, let's check whose answer is correct. 5. 7 plus 0, 7. 8 plus 10, 18. So here 6, here 3, here 1. Children, take your own time and add it properly. I know most of them will do mistakes while adding it, okay? Some students will forget to add the carryover. Some students will do the mistakes while adding it. So please avoid it. Once after finish the problem, check your problems twice or thrice, okay? So the answer is 1,36,875. How many of you getting the answer? Yes, Sadhana, Ekant, check your answer, Kanam. Samaira, Abhishek, yes, good job, children, very good. And Sadhana, write it neatly, dear, okay. I was checking your clutter while checking. You are not maintaining the space in between the numbers. So leave one finger space so that you will get neat. Okay, you won't confuse while adding the digits. Okay, Sadhana? Got? How, Ishanvi, check it? Kritiya, check it. Check your answer. 1,36,875 is the correct answer. Okay, 1,36,875 is the correct answer. Yes, Jason Roy, good. No, Digan, check your answer. Yes, that's what I am telling, no? Children, while doing the addition, you will do mistakes. So, twice or thrice, check your problem. Shall we move on to the next question? Yes, Diya, you are right. Yes. Okay. Children, you no need to worry that you couldn't follow me, you couldn't start write your classwork, you couldn't complete your classwork. No issues, okay? Anyway, I'll be sharing the worksheets. You can copy it from that after finishing your classes. Let's move on to the next question. Yes, Akshaya, I know we have 6 minutes more. Question number 4, and today we have homework period, no? We'll solve the remaining problems in the homework classes, okay? Yes, question number 4. Priyanka goes to the Ranthambore National Park with her parents and 5 friends, okay? With her parents. Parents means how many? Count, can you please tell me the total count of the students? So including Priyanka and her parents and along with her 5 friends. Can you tell me the total count? So how many of them are visiting the national park? Can you please tell me the total count? 8. Yes. Thank you, Digan. Thank you, Dhiran. Thank you, Shanvi. Yes, 8. Okay. So Priyanka is one count. Next, along with her parents. So parents means mama and papa. Okay. Father and mother. So, Priyanka, father and mother, 3 members. Then, along with the 5 friends. So, totally 8. Now, look at the first question. The cab driver charges 9 rupees per kilometer. How many rupees? 9 rupees per kilometer. In all, they travel 1,929 kilometers. How much money do they pay to the driver? So, totally they have traveled... Listen, children, totally they have traveled 1,929 kilometer. Okay, 1,929 kilometer. So, per kilometer, 9 rupees. Per kilometer, 9 rupees. Got it? So, now we are going to find that how much money does she pay to the driver. Okay? Solution. Distance covered by the driver is equal to 1,929 kilometer. The driver charges per kilometer is equal to 9 rupees. So we are going to do the multiplication of 1,929 into 9. So children, here we have only one digit. So you will get the answer in only one line. Okay? Got it, children? If you are going to multiply the number by only one digit number, means you will get the answer in one line. Okay. So now I'm going to multiply it. I'm going to start multiply. 9 are 81. 1 here, 8 will be the carryover. Children, listen. The first digit you should write and second digit will be the carryover. Some students will do ulta bulta. Please avoid it. Okay. First number you should write down and second number will be the carryover. 9 twos are 18. 18 plus 8. 18 plus 8 how much? 18 plus, yes, very good. Thank you, Prakar. 26. 9 plus 9 nines are 81. 81 plus 2. 81 plus 2, 83. Next, 9 ones are 9. 9 plus 8. 17. Wow, Jashwant, good job. So 17,361 rupees. Okay, how much they are paying? 17,361 rupees. So the total amount paid by Priyanka is equal to 17,361 rupees. Okay, children, it's time up. Remaining problems we'll solve it during homework period. We have homework class now, so try to join. And listen, children, I need to give you some announcement.